This is Janet Andrabir.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this video, we are going to define the compound or the physical pendulum, give the expression of the mechanical energy of the compound pendulum-Earth system, determine the differential equation that governs the motion of the undamped compound pendulum, introduce the solution of the differential equation and give the expressions of omega 0 and t 0.
The physical pendulum or the compound pendulum is a rigid object that oscillates under the action of its weight about a horizontal axis which is not passing through its center of mass. Now, our physical pendulum consists of a rigid rod, and here we have an object fixed to this position. Now, let's say that the center of mass of our pendulum is in this position. I will start now the oscillations of the pendulum. Now, in this position, the pendulum is in its stable equilibrium position. So I will displace the pendulum from its stable equilibrium position, and then I will release it from rest. So as you see, the pendulum oscillates about a horizontal axis which passes through the upper end of the pendulum, but not through its center of mass.
Expression of the mechanical energy of the system pendulum-Earth. Consider the compound or the physical pendulum of the figure. This pendulum oscillates about a horizontal axis delta passing through a point O. G is the center of mass of the pendulum, or is the point at which the whole mass of the pendulum is considered to be concentrated. G0 is the lowest position of G, or the position of G at the equilibrium position. A represents the distance between O and G. Theta is the angular abscess of the pendulum, or the angle between OG0 and OG. Now, the expression of the mechanical energy is given by KE plus GPE. KE is equal to 1 half I theta prime squared, and the GPE is equal to MGZ of G. I is the moment of inertia of the pendulum about the axis of rotation, delta. Theta prime is the angular speed of the pendulum. M is the mass of the pendulum. And Z of G is the altitude of the center of mass relative to the reference level for the gravitational potential energy. In our example, the reference level for the gravitational potential energy is the horizontal plane passing through G0. Now, relative to this reference level, Z of G is equal to GH or equal to AG0. Now, we have to determine the expression of Z of G or AG0. As you see from the figure, AG0 is equal to OG0 minus OA. But OG0 is equal to OG is equal to A. Now, what is the expression of OA? Consider the triangle OGA. Cosine theta is equal to the adjacent OA over the hypotenuse A. Then OA is equal to A cosine theta. So Z of G is equal to A minus A cosine theta is equal to A into 1 minus cosine theta. Now, replace Z of G by A into 1 minus cosine theta, we get the expression of ME as shown. ME is equal to 1 half I theta prime squared plus MGA into 1 minus cosine theta. When the pendulum oscillates for a small angle, or the maximum angle is less than or equal 10 degrees, cosine theta is approximately equal 1 minus theta squared over 2. So, replace cosine theta by 1 minus theta squared over 2, we get the gravitational potential energy, MGA into 1 minus 1 plus theta squared over 2. 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. Finally, we get the expression of the mechanical energy of the system for small angles as shown. ME is equal to 1 half I theta prime squared plus 1 half MGA theta squared.
Remark, Take into account that the expression of the gravitational potential energy depends on the position of the reference level. So let's take a reference level as the horizontal plane passing through O. Now we need to determine the expression of ZG. But where is ZG? ZG is equal to minus OA, and ZG is negative because the center of mass of the pendulum is below the reference level. Now we need to determine the expression of OA. Consider the right angled triangle OGA, cosine theta, is equal to the adjacent OA over the hypotenuse A. So OA is equal to A cosine theta. This is going to be ZG is equal to minus A cosine theta. Now we have the expression of the mechanical energy, 1 half I theta prime squared plus mgz. Now replace ZG by minus A cosine theta. This is going to be ME is equal to 1 half I theta prime squared minus mgA cosine theta. Now, let's determine the differential equation that governs the preondant oscillations of the compound pendulum. Now, the oscillations of the pendulum are undamped if friction is neglected. And in this case, the mechanical energy of the pendulum earth system is conserved. But also, we can say the sum of the works done by the non-conservative forces is zero, and therefore the mechanical energy is conserved. Now, we have ME is equal to 1 half I theta prime squared plus 1 half mgA theta squared, which is equal to constant. Let's differentiate both sides of this equation with respect to time. So, 1 half I is constant, so it stays the same. The variable is theta prime squared, and its derivative is 2 theta prime theta double prime. Similarly, 1 half mgA is constant, so the variable is theta squared, and its derivative is 2 theta theta prime, and the derivative of the constant is 0. Now, the half and the 2 cancel out in the first term and in the second term. So this is going to be. Now we take theta prime as a common factor. You have theta prime is equal to 0, or and I theta double prime plus mgA theta is equal to 0. But the first choice is rejected. Theta prime equals 0 is rejected because the angular speed of the compound pendulum is not always zero. It is only zero at the extreme positions, and that when theta is equal to plus minus theta max. So we will go to the second choice. I theta double prime plus mgA theta is equal to zero. Divide the equation by I. So this is going to be theta double prime plus mgA over I times theta is equal to zero. This is the second order differential equation that governs the variation of theta for a compound or a physical pendulum.
Focus, please. This is important.
In addition to the principle of conservation of mechanical energy, we can use Newton's second law in rotation or the theorem of the angular momentum to determine the differential equation of motion. In this case, we take the pendulum as the system, so the external forces acting on the pendulum are the reaction R at the axis of rotation delta and the weight of the pendulum mg at its center of mass g. As you see, the weight is parallel to OG0, so these two angles are called corresponding angles. Then the angle between the weight and OG is equal to theta. Now applying Newton's second law in rotation. The sum of the moment of the external forces acting on the pendulum is equal to the time derivative of the angular momentum of the pendulum about delta. Since the moment of inertia I of the pendulum is constant, so d sigma by dt is equal to I theta double prime, where theta double prime is the angular acceleration of the pendulum. Then the moment of R plus the moment of the weight mg is equal to I theta w prime. But the moment of r is equal to zero since r intersects the axis of rotation delta. And the moment of the weight is equal to minus mgA sine theta. Minus because the weight tends to return the pendulum back to its equilibrium position. For theta positive, the moment of the weight is negative. For theta negative, the moment of the weight is positive. A sine theta represents the smallest distance between the weight and the axis of rotation. A, as you know, is equal to OG. For small angles, sine theta is approximately theta in radius. So the moment of the weight for small angles can be written as minus mgA theta. Now, replacing the moment of the weight by zero, the moment of r by zero, the moment of the weight by minus mgA theta, so minus mgA theta is equal to I theta w prime. Dividing by I both sides, we get the differential equation as shown, theta w prime plus mgA over I times theta is equal to zero. Nature of motion. Since the differential equation is of the form of theta w prime plus omega 0 squared theta is equal to zero, with omega 0 squared equal mgA over I being a positive constant, therefore the nature of the motion of the compound or the physical pendulum is simple harmonic motion or angular simple harmonic motion since we have rotation. Now, time equation or solution of the obtained differential equation. The solution of the obtained differential equation has the form of theta equal a sine omega 0 t plus phi or theta equal a cosine omega 0 t plus phi, where a, omega 0 and phi are constant. A could be negative or positive. So the absolute value of a is equal to theta m, which is called the amplitude of oscillation. And as you know, the amplitude is always positive. Sine omega 0 t plus phi or cosine omega 0 t plus phi varies between minus 1 and the plus 1. So we can conclude that theta varies between minus theta m and the plus theta m. Omega 0 is called the angular frequency of the oscillation. Omega 0 t plus phi is called the phase angle of the oscillation. And phi is called the initial phase angle. So one of the preceded videos explained the meaning of these properties. So you can watch this video to understand the physical meaning of these properties.
Now, let's move to the expression of the angular frequency. As we have seen in the last slide, omega 0 squared is equal to mgA over I. So the expression of the natural angular frequency is the square root of mgA over I. Now this expression shows that omega 0 is a positive quantity. Recall that the SI unit of omega 0 is radians per second. Let's move to the natural period. You know that T0 is equal to 2 pi over omega 0. Replace omega 0 by the square root of mgA over I. This is going to be T0 is equal to 2 pi times the square root of I over mgA. Recall that the SI unit of the natural period is seconds. Let's move to the natural frequency. F0 is equal to 1 over T0, so replace T0 by 2 pi over omega 0. This is going to be F0 is equal to omega 0 over 2 pi. Remember that the SI unit of F0 is Hertz. Now, if you are interested in the physical meanings of omega 0 and F0, watch the video whose title is Time Equation of Motion of a Horizontal Elastic Pendulum. Finally, let's discuss this remark. If the axis of rotation passes almost through the center of mass G of the system, then A tends to zero, because A is the distance between the center of mass and the axis of rotation. So in this expression, if A tends to zero, then T0 tends to infinity, thus we have no oscillations. Actually, if the system is suspended from its center of mass, then it will rotate about the axis of rotation, and therefore it will not oscillate.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.